CS50C programming போட்டிங்கன்னா வில் கெட் தி லிங்க். ஸோ இந்த லிங்க்ல போனீங்கன்னா ஒன் ஆஃப் தி மோஸ்ட் ஃபேமஸ் கோர்ஸ் அண்ட் மோஸ்ட் பாப்புலர் கோர்ஸ் இன் ஹார்வர்ட் யூனிவர்சிட்டி. திஸ் இஸ் ஃப்ரம் யூஎஸ். யூஎஸ்ல ஹார்வர்ட் காலேஜில் இன்ஜினியரிங் காலேஜ்லேருந்து டீச் பண்ணுறாங்க. ஸோ அதில் வந்து வீக் ஜீரோ வந்து தேர் இஸ் லாங்குவேஜ் கால் ஸ்க்ராட்ச். ஸோ உங்களுக்கு இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் இருந்தால் நீங்கள் பார்க்கலாம். இட்ஸ் அண்ட் மேபி நீங்கள் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் பண்ணியிருப்பீங்கன்னு நினைக்கிறேன். ஸோ ஸ்க்ராட்ச் வந்து ரொம்ப ஜாலியான ப்ரோக்ராமிங். ரொம்ப போர் அடிக்குதுன்னு நினச்சிங்கன்னா இட் கேன் ட்ரை வித் ஸ்க்ராட்ச். அனிமேஷனில் மாதிரியே நீங்கள் வந்து கோடிங் எழுதவே தேவையில்லை, எல்லாம் ட்ராக் அண்ட் ட்ராப்லேயே வந்து ஸ்க்ராட்ச் பண்ணலாம், சாரி கோட் பண்ணலாம். அண்ட் ஃபுல்லாக எல்லாமே இருக்கும், அவங்களோட ஆடியோ லெக்சர்ஸ், நோட்ஸு, ஸ்லைட்ஸு, குவிஸு, லேபு எல்லாமே வந்து அவைலபிள் ஆன்லைன். எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் ஃபார் ஃப்ரீ, எல்லாமே ஃப்ரீயாக வந்து நீங்கள் யூஸ் பண்ணிக்க முடியும். இதில் காலையில் நான் பார்த்துட்டு இருக்கும்போது ஐ காட் டு திஸ் ஸ்லைடு. இப்போ வந்து கரண்டாக கிளாஸ் எப்படி போகுது அப்படின்றதுக்கு வந்து ஸ்லைட்ஸுமே ஃப்ரீயாக கொடுக்குறாங்க. இதர் யூ கேன் டவுன்லோட் இட் ஆஸ் அ பிடிஎஃப் ஃபார் கூகுள் ஸ்லைட்ஸில் வந்து ஓப்பன் ஆகுது. கிளாஸ் பாருங்கள். ஸோ இப்போதைக்கு கரண்ட்டாக ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸ் இப்படி தான் போகுது. எவ்வளோ பெரிய ஹால் இருக்குன்னு பாருங்கள். இந்த ஹாலில் வந்து தே ஹாவ் ஸோ மெனி ஸ்க்ரீன்ஸ், எல்லாமே வந்து ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸோட ஸ்க்ரீன்ஸு வித் வீடியோ வீடியோவோட இருக்குது. அப்புறம் இவங்களுக்கு வந்து இங்கே கேமரா வச்சுருக்காங்க. கேமரா சிடி கேமரா ஹியர், ஆளே கிடையாது, ஆள் இல்லாத கேமரா. அண்ட் இங்கே ஒரு ஆள் நிற்கிறாங்க, இ குட் பி இன் வீடியோ கிராஃபர். நீங்க போய் பாருங்க, நிறைய கோர்ஸ் வந்து ஃப்ரீயா கொடுத்துருக்காங்க, ஜஸ்ட் சும்மா போய் பாருங்களேன். நான் வந்து ஒன் ஆஃப் மை ஃபேவரட் சப்ஜெக்ட் இஸ் ஃபிசிக்ஸ். ஃபிசிக்ஸ் அதில் வந்து குவாண்டம் கம்ப்யூட்டிங் இஸ் ஒன் ஆஃப் மை ஃபேவரட் சப்ஜெக்ட். ஸோ அதில் வந்து ஐ கோ அண்ட் வாட்ச் குவாண்டம் கம்ப்யூட்டிங் பார்ப்போம். அப்புறம் ஐன்ஸ்டீன்ஸ் தியரி, E=mc². குவாண்டம்ல நிறையா கான்செப்ட்ஸ் இருக்குது, டெலிபோர்டேஷன் அந்த மாதிரிலாம். ஸோ அதே மாதிரி எப்படி தான் டீச் பண்ணுறாங்க, நம்ம ஊரில் காலேஜஸில் டீச் பண்ணுறோம், நான் எப்படி டீச் பண்ணுறேன், இந்த மக்கள்லாம் எப்படி டீச் பண்ணுறாங்க, இந்த ப்ரொஃபஸர்ஸ்லாம் எப்படி டீச் பண்ணுறாங்க அப்படின்னு போய் நான் பார்ப்பேன். நான் ரொம்ப இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங்கான செஷன்ஸ்லாம் போகும், ரொம்ப இன்ட்ராக்டிவாக வந்து என்னோடய கிளாஸ் இல்லாத மாதிரி, மோனோ லாபா இல்லாத மாதிரி ரொம்ப அங்கே வந்து இன்ட்ராக்டிவாக கிளாஸ். ஒன் ரீசன் இஸ் வி ஆர் ஃபிசிக்கலி ப்ரெசன்ட், அதனால வந்து இட் இஸ் மோர் கம்ஃபர்டபுள். இமீடியட் ஃபீட்பேக் வந்து வி குட் கெட் ஆன்லைன் அப்படி இல்லை. ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஹவ் கரண்ட்லி இட் இஸ் கோயிங் ஆன் இன் யூஎஸ். ஸோ இதுக்கு சொல்லுவாங்க. So you can go and definitely I recommend this course. You can go and learn a lot. Nariya learn pannala. And YouTube la we have all the videos. So the week one la the CEO oda lectures mattume paatha porom, you can get a whole idea week one la. And this one video around 2 hours irukum nenikiran. The total entire idea on C vandu avanga kuduthirukanga. So I also recommend everyone of you to watch this. Depending if you watch it, really, very, very, very nice. At least, I am going to do C programming. That's why I am going to do C programming. This one I want to say. Okay. So we'll go with the... மார்னிங்கில் வந்து ஐ வாஸ் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் அ ப்ராப்ளம். என்ன ப்ராப்ளம்னு சொல்லிட்டு இருந்தோம், இன்ட்ரடியூஸ் ஸ்கேன்அப் ரைட். ஸ்கேன்அப் சொல்லிட்டு ஆஃப்டர்நூனில் வி வில் ட்ரை ஒன் ப்ராப்ளம், அதாவது நேற்று கொடுத்த ஹோம்ஒர்க், லாஸ்ட் கிளாஸில் கொடுத்த ஹோம்ஒர்க் வந்து நம்ம ட்ரை பண்ணலாம்னு சொல்லியிருந்தோம். ஸோ யூசிங் ஸ்கேன்அப் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு கெட் 5 மார்க்ஸ். 5 மார்க்ஸ் வாங்கிட்டு தென் வில் ஃபைண்ட் தி ஆவரேஜ், டோட்டல் அண்ட் ஆவரேஜ் ஆஃப் தி கிவன் 5 மார்க்ஸ் ரைட் ஃபார். ஓகே, ஸோ வி நீட் first we need to decide on data. So enna data venum, whenever a problem is given, first thing is we need to get the ingredients. Eppadi cooking la என்ன ஒரு ரெசிபி பண்ணாலும் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் விஷயம் என்ன பார்ப்போம், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் திங் இஸ் தேவையான பொருட்கள் இல்லையா, வாட் ஆர் தி இன்கிரீடியன்ஸ் நீடட் ஃபார் மேக்கிங் தி ரெசிபி. ஸோ தட் இஸ் தி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் திங் தட் கம்ஸ் டு அஸ் கம் டு அவர் மைண்ட். ஸோ அன்லஸ் வி ஹாவ் தி ரெக்வயர்டு இன்கிரீடியன்ஸ் வி கே நாட் மேக் தி ரெசிபி. ஹவு குட் ஐ மே பி எ குக், பட் இஃப் ஐ டோன்ட் ஹாவ் தி ப்ராப்பர் இன்கிரீடியன்ஸ் ஃபார் மேக்கிங் தி ரெசிபி, தென் ஐ கே நாட் மேக் த ரெசிபி. ஸோ தட் இஸ் ஹியர் டேட்டா இஸ் தி ரெசிபி. ஸோ வென் எவர் அ ப்ராப்ளம் இஸ் கிவன், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் வாட் ஆர் தி திங்ஸ் ஐ நீடட் ஃபார் சால்விங் தி ப்ராப்ளம் ஃபார் மேக்கிங் தி ரெசிபி. ஸோ ஹியர் த க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் கெட் 5 marks and find the total and average. So this is the question. So what all we needed? We need to get 5 marks. So if I want to get 5 marks, I need 5 variables for storing those values. I'm going to get 5 values. I need to store it somewhere. Then only I can able to process it. So therefore I need 5 variables for getting marks. Then also I need to calculate the total and average. So I also need a memory location for storing the total, and also I need a memory location for storing the average. So therefore I need how many locations? 5 memory location for storing integer, and one for total and one for average. So we need 7 memory location for storing the values, and for processing the values. And once we decide how many memory location we need, the next thing is what you have to do is what is the data type of that data. Now vaanga pora data oda data type and what is the type of value I'm going to get, whether it is a whole number, whether it is a fractional number, whether it is a character or it is a collection of character, or it is an image or it is a video file. So whatever may be the input, then we need to find out what is the type of input that we are going to get. So that is the next thing that we have to think and decide. First, we need what are all the data I need. Once I decide upon the data, then I have to store it in a memory location. So while storing it in a memory location, it is mandatory that we need to specify what is the type of data that we are going to store. So that is most important thing, but which is not the same case in Python. So whenever we are storing something in a variable using Python, we don't define the data type. What is the data type that will be stored in that memory location? Because Python is very, very advanced language, and it does automatically, it has the knowledge, it is so smart, it can automatically find out what is the type of data while we are assigning the value itself. So in Python, if I say a is equal to 10, so it is 10, right? So Python will automatically understand that it is an integer. If I say a is equal to 10.5, Python will automatically understand it is a fractional value. If I say Python a is equal to Sona, then Python will understand that it is a string. But C is an old language, right? It is not so smart. Also, C supports, we can also include assembly language inside your C. So that is why there are so many, you know, small things we need to remember and we need to practice. So first we need to find the data, or what are all the data we need, and then what are all the data types of those data. So once we decide on that, then we can use the variables. So first we need to say, I am going to have marks can be float also, you know. In our college, all your marks will be not integers. All your marks will be in floating form. So provide marks, we have precision of your marks up to 2 decimal points. So if you got a chance to see your internal marks, I think internal marks will be rounded off. Yeah, internal marks will be rounded off, but your CAE test marks will be having precision up to 2 decimal points. So let us, for ease of use, let us say we have மார்க்ஸ் இன் இன்டீஜர்ஸ். டோட்டல் ஸ்கோர் டோட்டல் So this is called as a declaration. Declaration. What is meant by declaration? I am informing the computer that computer, I am going to be needing all these variables and its memory location. So in my program, I am going to use 5 variables of integer type and 2 variables of float type. So that is what it is called as a declaration. So this declaration will not happen in Python. You can never see a code in Python simply say A or simply say B. In Python, we always use A is equal. We always store some value. So there is no concept of declaration in Python, but we have to declare it, or we can do both, declare and assign. So that can be done in C, but in Python we don't have declaration. We directly assign values to a variable. So this is called declaration, and then we'll have okay. We got all the variables. Okay, next step is scanner for reading. First we'll do it simply. We're going to get 5 marks, right? So where we are going to store? We are going to store it in M1, M2, M3, M4. What is the type of M1? It is integer. So I have to tell get the value. What is going to be the value type? It is going to be integer. So it is percentage D. And where it is to be stored? It is to be stored, comma, it is to be stored in M1. Don't forget to put the ampersand. So there is a meaning for ampersand. It will be discussed while we are discussing pointer. So same thing will be repeated again and again. So I'm going to copy and paste it. So you don't have to put everything in the separate line. So what we can do is we can bring everything in a single line also. So this is possible. So let me have these things. We can do like this also. So it is possible. This is possible because we have semicolon. So what is the meaning of semicolon? The meaning of semicolon is this symbol will tell the computer that the line has completed. Line has completed, which means the line has ended here. That is the meaning of semicolon. So what the computer will think is this is a different line and it is ended here, and the next line is starting here and it is ended here, and the next line is started here, it is ended here, then it will read the next line, right? So it will think like that. So once we got all the numbers, then we need to find the total. So total is equal to something plus average is equal to right. So we all calculated, everything is available in our memory. Then we need to show the answers on your screen. So that use print f. So in Python we call it as print. Here we call it as print f. Then what is the value I'm going to store? I'm going to show total. What is the data type of total? Floating. So it should be I am going to store show a floating value, therefore percentage of reports comma. Going to show average is of floating type, so it should be percentage. Yeah? What is the value to be shown? Whatever the value which is stored in application. Okay. Return 0. Is that done? Let us run it and see. Let us compile it and see. Let us compile it first. So there is no error. Says zero error, zero warning. Everything is perfect. So now what happened is this will generate a file called a.out. So let me go to my desktop and you can see a file called marks.exe. So what is a machine code? We know a computer will always understand a machine code. So what a compiler does, a compiler will take my source code and it will convert it into machine code. Machine code is nothing but your executable file. So for Windows, you know, whenever you want to install a software, it's an exe file, .exe format. So your compiler will automatically create, after compilation, it will automatically create an exe file. For Linux operating system, there is a format called binary format. So it will be dot out. And for Mac, I don't know. For Mac, what is the executable format? It should also be dot out then again. And a Mac is from Unix, so it supports all the Linux commands. So Mac, it will generate a file called a dot out. So in the file, yeah, who generated this file? This file is generated by the compiler, mark.exe. If I delete it, let me delete it. Let me delete it and see what will happen. So I'm deleting all the O file and E file. Now I have marks.exe. That is my file name. If I compile it, so I'm just compiling it, what happens? It will convert all here. It will first check everything is working correctly or not, syntactically, whether everything is correctly or not. And then it will convert the file into binary, executable file. Compile, everything is done. Now, if I go to my desktop and refresh it, you can see it's created. And if I can double click it, it will run. It is running. So I can directly view marks, say 50. Okay. I have pressed extra one enter, so it went away. So this is how you can share. If suppose I develop a software using C, and if I want to sell it, what I will do? I will just simply share this to or sell this to my clients. So they will, what they will do, they will simply install it and they will simply run it. So let me again do it. So okay, there's a problem with this problem, but we have to write additional code for making the window stable. So we'll do that later. Say, so let us run and see. So here it is running here itself, here and now there. So I need to enter 5 marks, say 50, 50, 60. What is telling me? So the total is 270 and then the average is 54. So let us add some additional information. So it is total, right? So it is total colon space slash n average. Also, we can add some info before scanning. So, you know, I will say vector I run it. So build and run. Okay, you can see our program has an error. What is the error? Can anyone find out what is the error? We can read the error. No error, pa. What is the error? Yeah, the Dushyant.
Sixth line, sir.
Yes, you can see. But if you see here, it says line number error in line number 7. Expected, you know, semicolon before. So what I do, I go to and see line number 7 and check whether is there any error. So everything is perfect. So what I will do, then I go to the line before and I will see whether everything is works fine or not. No, here we are missing a semicolon. So one of the major problem everyone will face, even I face, is I will fail to put the semicolon. So whenever your program is not running, just check whether you put the semicolon in the all the lines. So let us run it again. Working. Enter 5 marks. So let me enter some marks. So total is 250, the average is. And now you can see the return is 0. So in the morning, there was an error, right? So the program abnormally stops somewhere. In this case, it says return some negative number. So whenever you see a return as a negative number, we can understand that something went wrong. The program has terminated or aborted in between due to some error, logical runtime error. So those errors are called runtime errors. So while running my program, the program has started and in between it went somewhere wrong, it stopped abnormally. So those errors are called as runtime error. While running, I'm getting the runtime error. Right. We can also see the execution time. So what is the amount of time taken by this program to print the total number? It says 8 seconds. It will include the time I took to enter all the 5 marks. So from starting, enter 5 marks, then I took some time for entering the first 50, second 50, third 50, fourth 50 and fifth 50. So all the times are included, and then it also take the time for my computer to do the addition and calculate the average. So those times will also be included. So it takes totally 8.91 seconds. For your computer, it may be totally different. If you have a faster computer, the time will be reduced. If you have a less speed computer, if you have a processor which is very old processor, Intel Core Duo or some other processor, or if you are running it in a mobile, old mobile, then the time may be more. Okay, so we'll stop with this. So if you have any doubts, you can ask. If not clarity, you can ask. Then I will post your question, lab question in Hacker. I have already posted. So there will be totally 5 questions. 5 questions are given. Last 3 questions you have to complete it by today. Last 3 questions. Deadline is today evening. Today evening, or what should we do? Anyway, okay, we will do like this. All the 5 questions, you can take 2 days' time till the weekend. So Sunday, by Sunday, you have to complete it. So all the timings are already set in the HackerRank. So it will be automatically displayed when the time is over. So you can take 3 days' time, 3 days or 2 days' time, from today afternoon, tomorrow and Sunday, and try to complete all the 5 programs. The first two or three problems is given by Aldo sir, and the remaining problems are given by myself. So for that, the question which is given by Aldo sir, you need to learn loops, for loop and while loop. So if you find time, you can explore it on your own and try to solve the problem. Let us see how many of you are solving it. And for the last 3 problem, what I did is I took the previous Python programs, simple Python programs, and I put the same question. Now you have to convert those problems into programs into C programs. So it's an easy task actually. So you can try it out, and this is one way company works. So there are companies, what they will do is they will simply take the older code in a different language and they will convert the exact code into a newer language. Many of my friends have done that. They may be having code in C. What their job is, they have to take that code and they have to convert the code into Java, or they may have to convert it into Python, whatever the language is asked by the company. So they have old code, the new technology arrives, right? So we need to adapt. So they take the old code and convert it into a new language. And I will show the questions also for you. What are the questions that has to be solved? I want your comments on the joke that I said in the beginning. If you wish, you can personally send your comment about the joke, whether it is good, bad, or worse. I can improve on the joke part. So the first problem is, this is our first problem. We have already discussed it. 3 friends are going to a trip. Hold on. The question is, the three friends are going for a trip. They decided to share the total cost. So how much the fuel cost, how much they travel, the total fuel cost will be shared by all those three friends. So this is the problem. So the data that is given us, we will be giving what is the today's fuel cost per liter. So that will be given. Sorry, what is this? What the mileage. So the mileage which is given by the vehicle, and what is the fuel cost per liter, and how many kilometers the friend have traveled. This is a one-way travel. So we need to calculate for the total travel. So total travel, now multiply your answer by 2. So that will be given. And what we have to find is, we need to find, so how many friends are going? 3 friends are going. So we need to tell how many, what is to be found, right? Okay. So per person, how much they have to pay. So this is the question. So find the total cost and divide it by 3. So that will be the answer. So we don't have to print the true part. And make sure that you have a decimal point, which means you have to use a float, and it is only one decimal point. So it should be percentage 0.1f, the printf statement. So this is one problem. And the other problem is, lighting. Again, this is already treated in Python. Lightical calculation. Again, we need to find the round tip amount for the total cost for ticket. Ticket cost available for round trip Mumbai to Dubai. So this is for adult, and for children, it is one third of the total cost. So this is for one person. So if it is a child, then it is 1/3 of this cost. And plus, we need to find the 7% of the service tax to be added with the amount. And then we need to finally give the discount on the final cost after including the service tax. So first, include everything, calculate everything, including the service tax, and find the total ticket amount, how much it is cost for the travel. And then with the final amount, reduce 10% from that amount. That will be your final amount. So here the sample given along with the answer. So for here, what we can do is, we maintain a 2-digit for both the values. And finally, the last problem is, again, the same problem that we discussed in Python. So here, a student, we need to find the college fee for a student. So this is actually the total fee. Course fee will be given, and there is an entrance score. So suppose if the score is 50, then she is given a the person is given a scholarship amount of 50% of the marks that she or he scored. Right, so we need to reduce this mark. So 50% of the mark, that is 25% of the mark, 25% of the discount is given, scholarship is given on the total amount. So if the total amount is 25,000, so it is 25,000, then find out what is 25% of 25,000, then subtract it here. So that will be given here, total fee, plus you need to add this extra fee. That is 1,500. Then find, this will be given you total college fee. So this is your last problem. Hope you understand all these problems. If you have any difficulty, you can always, you know, ping me. You can always contact me through WhatsApp. You know, give me a call. We can discuss it. So that's it from my side. If you want to ask anything or anything else, want to tell, you can tell. Any questions? Ella thoongitingla?
Sir.
Hello, Surya.
சார் அந்த exe ஃபைல் வந்து என்டர் இன்புட்லாம் என்டர் பண்ணவுனே ஸ்டில்லா அப்படியே நிக்கணும்னா இது கோட் எழுதணும்னு சொன்னீங்கல்ல சார், அது என்ன கோட்னு ஒரே ஒரு தடவை சொல்லிருங்க சார்.
ஒண்ணுல ஒரு ஸ்கேன் ஆஃப் போட்றங்க அவங்க. ஜஸ்ட் ஸ்டார்ட் அஸ். There is no purpose for this line. The purpose for this line is to make the window stable, available, stick to the desktop.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Let us say, let's check whether it is working or not. We will delete all the. Compile. So this is waiting, the screen is still waiting. The reason is because you can see the cursor is blinking. Actually it is waiting for an input which is a dummy input. The purpose of the scan is to make this screen stick, make the screen visible. Suppose if you fail to put the scan, what happens is once 50 is entered, total and average will be displayed, immediately it will be closed. So it is very, very fast that we could not see the output. So that is why we had a scan up. So if I put some number, it accepts, it will accept. If I press enter, it will immediately vanish.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
And you can also explore this file. There is a file called marks.o, and you can open and see. It is an object file. You could not understand anything. So if you wish to know, you can go and explore it. So yeah, we'll share the link. This link. It's in WhatsApp ADS group. So I've shared the link in here, HackerRank in here. WhatsApp ADS group. So we have question number 678 is by myself, and question number 345 is by Aldo sir. For solving all the 345 questions, you need to know the concept of loops in C program. So you already know what is the meaning of loop in Python and all. So the only thing what you have to learn is the syntax, how I should use while in C, or how should I use for loop in C language. So you can learn on your own and just give it a try. So we have three how many times, how much time to put on it, is not loading.
Sir, சார் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ப்ரோக்ராம் வந்துட்டு பைத்தான்ல எழுதுற மாதிரி ஆப்ஷன் கொடுத்துருக்கீங்க சார்.
ஐயோ மாத்திடலாம், அதுல சேஞ்ச் லாங்குவேஜ் இருக்கும், ப்ளீஸ் டூ இட் இன் சி. பா அதுல யூ கேன்
சார். இல்லைங்க சார், வேற ஆப்ஷன் இல்லைங்க சார், வெறும் பைத்தான் மட்டும் தான் சார்.
ஓ, ஸோ ஐ வில் சேஞ்ச் இட் நவ். ஸோ இட் இஸ் அவைலபிள் டில் 11:45. என்ன மக்கபல் என்ன பண்றீங்க? 4/11/2020 வரைக்கும் இருக்கு. 11 டில் சண்டே நைட், டில் சண்டே மிட் நைட். வாட் இஸ் தட் திங்? ஐ நீட் டு சேஞ்ச் இட். ஓகே, ஐ வில் சேஞ்ச் இட். நான் சேஞ்ச் பண்ணிடுறேன். லெட் மீ செக் வெதர் இட்ஸ் நாட். So can you check the program C lateral calculation? Refresh பண்ணி செக் பண்ணுங்க. what language are you using?
So that units and 10 digits, that's some sir, that's some still we are getting the Python sir.
Yeah, மத்தது நான் மாத்துறோம். I just want to make sure that whether it is working or not. If that one is working, problem. So I was talking about a language called COBOL, and still it is available in the old language. But if you learn, it's a new demand. Today we have a demand for old languages because people don't study the old languages nowadays. They are always going for the latest languages. So therefore, we could not find people on people who know old programming languages. If you're interested, can learn old languages and get quick. இப்போ எப்படி இருக்கு? வெதர் கெட்டிங் இல்லை